Hello students, today we are going to start a new unit called exponential functions and logarithmic functions. In that, our goal today is to understand exponential functions. For studying exponential functions, a concept of a one-to-one function is very much relevant. So we will first study that concept. Then we will go to a definition of exponential function and the properties of exponential functions as we studied for polynomial and straight line case. Then we will define one interesting function which is called the natural exponential function. And I will justify why it is called natural and what are the properties that it shares with the mathematics world. So let us start. I think it's time to start and let us start. So first, let us go to a concept of one-to-one function. In order to define the concept of one-to-one function, let us quickly recall what is a function, a concept of a function. So whenever I talk about function, I will talk about y is equal to fx. This f, when I say I need some domain, let us say a, and I need some codomain. In general, function can be defined on any two sets. But for us, let us consider to simplify our understanding so that we will understand in terms of coordinate plane A and B to be subsets of real line. Okay. So now my domain according to this definition is A and codomain is B. So now what is a function? Function is a relation between one set to the other set. So it's a mapping that assigns values from one set to the values of other set. Let us describe this function as something like this. Okay. So let us see, this is the set A which we will call as domain, and this is the set B that we will call as codomain. This is A, this is B. What does the function do? If we feed some value of x from this set, it will process the value and spit out or give us fx. It's like a popcorn machine. You are feeding in the corn and getting out the popcorn. So this is how the function works. Now let us see what are the cases that can happen. Suppose for same value you are getting different outputs. That is the case when you consider 1x more than 1fx. Okay. So now, is this a function? Is a question mark. We will soon answer the question. Then it can so happen that you have fed two different values and you are getting the same input output. Okay. Is this a function? We will answer the question. And for every single output that you produce, there is a unique output that is produced by f. That is one fx only. So let us analyze these three. Again, is this a function? Yes. So let us analyze all these three things together. So let us start with the first case, that is 1x more than 1fx. What do I mean by 1x more than 1fx? Suppose I put x1. If I put x1 as a value, f once gave me f of x1, other time it gave me f of x1 which are not equal. Is this a function? Is this a well behaved function? It's not. So I will say no, this is not a function. Therefore, the first case I will say is not a function. Because we are dealing with coordinate plane, let us understand this function with a coordinate plane. So what happens here is, suppose I am taking the value, one value x1 on x-axis. Let us say this is x-axis, let us say this is y-axis. And now I am taking one value of x1. So once I fed in, I got something which is f of x1 here. And the other time I fed in, I got something which is f of x1 here. Now what is this? This is actually, if at all some curve I have to draw, it can be like this. And what happens here is for same value of x, you are getting two different values. Then your function is not well behaved, because I don't know which value will come when I feed in x1. So in that case, how will you identify whether something is a function or not? Sometimes if you have a graph of a function, the way it is given, it is very easy to see what is not a function. For example, if you take a line which is x is equal to a constant. If you take a line which is x is equal to a constant, and if I draw that line vertically, for example, let us say here, this is the line x is equal to a constant, x is equal to x1, in fact, I have drawn. So if I draw this line vertically, then I can see that there are two points at which this line intersects the graph of a function. When such a thing happens, we say a vertical line test. That is, this is a vertical line, right? It's a parallel to y-axis. Therefore, this line passes through two points. That means there is something fishy about the function, and we will use this as a vertical line test and say that because vertical line test fails, this particular function is not a function. Sorry, vertical vertical line test fails, and hence this cannot be a function. Can you imagine such a function? Can you imagine such a relation where this is not a function? For example, okay, let us not imagine right now. Let us come to the next case and generalize it to the other setup. Okay. So now let us see here. So first thing is not a function, that is very clear. Now let us take the second case, which is more than 1x and 1fx. Okay, so let us understand it on a paper. So there are more than 1x, x1 and x2, both are not equal. But somehow they give the output which is equal. In such case, what happens? So, as usual, general, this is a domain set A, this is a codomain B, F is processing unit, and I have fed in two different values of xi, but the output produced is same. So, is this a function or not? The answer is this is a function. And in this case, let us see how it happens. So let us have some understanding about x1 and x2. So naturally, x1 is not equal to x2. And I got f of x1, which is this, and I got f of x2, which is this. Both are same. And then how will the function look like? I can join a curve like this, where the function actually passes through these two points, and I have a curve like this. So if this is the curve, then these two points are same. And do you call this as a function? Yes, we call this as a function. Based on our understanding of the function lecture, we call this as a function. In this case, something interesting has happened. Let me analyze it in a more thorough manner. For example, when I considered the first case, let me go to the first case. I have drawn a vertical line, and I said that because of this vertical line, I can say this is not a function. I can say this is not a function. Now, the similar graph has appeared over here. But now, if I draw a horizontal line, I have a horizontal line which passes through two points. And I am saying it's a function. Correct? So if I rotate this graph by say 90 degrees and flip it over, then what I am getting is a graph similar to this function. So this actually helps me in understanding that if I want to write y as a function of x, I am able to write it. But if I want to write x as a function of y, that is simply just flip this rotate this by 90 degrees and flip the y axis, that will give you the exact understanding of the picture. And from this to this, I cannot go. And therefore, the horizontal line, if I draw, it passes through more than one point. So what will happen is, suppose if I take x1 here, if I take a point in this domain y1, and if I try to set up another processing unit, let us say g, and if I feed that y1 into g, what I get, if I use this f, I will not get something which is similar, that is, I will get something called g of y1 once, and if I feed in again y1, I will get something else as g of y1. That is what is happening. For example, here, if you locate this point is say y, then once you feed y into g, then g of y you will get as x1, and if you feed it other time, g of y you will get as x2. Now something interesting happens. What I am trying to do is, I am trying to reverse the function, and I can easily say that this function is not reversible. So this is an interesting point which will help us in gaining more understanding of exponential functions. So this function is not reversible, and a horizontal line test actually detects whether a function is reversible or not. So this horizontal line test fails. Horizontal line test actually fails in this case. So what happened here? Here, when you applied vertical line test, that is case 1, it was not at all a function. Here, it is a function. But our conclusion is, it is not reversible. Let us look at this third case where only one x is there and one fx is there. So here is x, fx. So if I substitute x1 and x2 as two different values, then I will get, through this processing unit, I will get f of x1 and I will get f of x2. And both of them will not be equal to each other, for x1 not equal to x2. That is the only way it can happen, right? 1x to 1fx. So if I take different fx, I will get different values. Okay. So what will be a typical behavior of such functions? Let us try to figure out. Let us say this is one function. So, is this function 1 to 1? The answer is yes, because if I take x1, x2 here, this is f of x1, this is f of x2. So for every one, if x1 is not equal to x2, f of x1 is not going to be equal to f of x2. Such function is called 1-to-1 function. And is it a function? It's a properly defined function. Yes. So now I can summarize using this as this is a function in earlier case we actually characterized whether it is reversible or not. What can you say about this new function that you have defined? This function. So now, because for x1 not equal to x2, f of x1 is not equal to f of x2. So if I start this as y1 and if I start with this as y2, I can easily retrace back x1 and x2. That is, g, there will be some function g such that x1 is equal to g of y1 and x2 is equal to g of y2. So this function in some sense is actually reversible. We will come to this point in more detail in the next section. Right now, remember that the function that is 1 to 1 is reversible and it is reversible. We need to be more precise and I will give you a word for reversible function in the later lectures, but right now it is an important observation that there are three cases. These three cases actually deal with a function. The first one is not a function. First one is not a function. Why? Because we are dealing with a coordinate plane. The vertical line test fails. When you pass a vertical line, that vertical line will pass through two points or more than two points, then it is not a function. Okay. So then we said the second case. The second case was more than one x and one fx. In this case, what happened is we were able to find a function properly, but we were not able to revert the function. So we said the function is not reversible. And on what basis we have said? We have said on the basis of horizontal test. Okay. And we have related this with our first case, that is, the if the function is not reversible, then the other part, that is g, is not also, is not a function as well. Third case, where we have one x and one fx, we showed that it is a function and it is reversible also. This brings us to a question that one-to-one functions, how easy are they to identify? How easy are they to identify? So let us properly define a one-to-one function. One in the domain, one in the codomain, and there is a clear-cut association that is given by two. So our definition, a function f is said to be one-to-one if for every x1 not equal to x2 which belong to the domain of a function, f of x1 is not equal to f of x2. The other interpretation is if f of x1 is equal to f of x2, this should imply x1 is equal to x2. This is the other interpretation of definition. But we will use this as a definition. But sometimes it may be difficult to prove this thing. In that case, you can prove the one written in the orange.